Everybody, Star here, and we've got some more Red Orchestra 2 because a lot of people asked for it, and the amount of people that asked for it was greater than the amount of people that said, "Why isn't this Team Fortress 2?" Anyway, this is Territory Control Mode. I am the Russian commander, and we are trying to lay siege on the Germans and take these apartments away from them because they have not been paying their rent. I immediately run towards this little basement here, get very aggressive in the beginning of rounds. You need to know when to run in and to get you behind all the stupid Germans who don't see you coming because they're like, "Hey, we're not even up this far yet ourselves. Why do you run so fast?" I don't know, maybe my Russian is actually Kenyan. Whatever the case may be, there weren't a lot of Germans here. Usually they have this room up here completely occupied, laying on the stairs guarding that. And that is not the case. It completely overlooks the courtyard we're supposed to be capturing, so it is a popular place. I come here to make sure things are going okay, but I'm a retard. No, you don't shoot your teammates. That's bad. That is not what I'm here to do. Obviously, and they're in the courtyard we're trying to capture. What is this? What is this? Is this a World War II flashback? Does that even make any sense? Why is it in grayscale? Why are all flashbacks in grayscale? What's even weirder is the fact that I've never even been in war. So how is this a war flashback? That doesn't make any sense. So I guess this must be me playing another game, the exact same route that I ran early in the match, and here's me coming up behind people. They're all guarding the door like I said they should be. They can get there that quickly, and here's me following up, watching the Germans come in to reinforce that area, and they are not ready for me to be there to show them the business. Usually this strategy does work. You can get in here pretty quickly and people don't expect it that often, and usually once you clear up these staircases up here, there's no point in staying here. So if you run down these hallways, that is where we just saw the massacre. Actually, at the end of this hallway is another staircase where the Germans run in, and I'm trying to get over there right now, but they are not letting me. And grenades are a mystery to me in this game. I could have sworn I got it through that door, but guess not. Not so good at throwing footballs in Russia, and it does not work out so well because he has an SMG and can just end me. Things are pretty much over. SMG is actually extremely effective on this map because it is so incredibly small. Most of the maps aren't such a small size, but SMG is awesome on here. Even in the longest distances, SMG doesn't really have a lot of drop-off at this point. Therefore, I'm actually using the SVT to gain the respect of my peers. A lot of people have been complaining about SMGs lately, so I figured I would look cool and make people think I'm cool if I use the rifle. Despite not having an awesome sauce SMG in what is the close-range battle of apartments, used to be Danzig and Red Orchestra 1, I am still being incredibly aggressive at getting behind these Germans so they don't see me shooting them in the butt. I love being aggressive on this, and you really need to. I stress it all the time that just don't stand around staring out windows. You can be extremely effective by running around like a tard. What is he doing there? There's no reason for him to be there. He is cowering. That's not what you want to do, so I run quickly forward here, hoping no enemies see me, and of course he does not. Get a quick kill on him. Unfortunately, the person who did see me was a teammate, and he was very focused on killing me, which is quite unfortunate. Sometimes being so aggressive, the actual downside to that is that you're going to be so far on the front lines that your teammates are going to only assume that you are an enemy. This is realism. There's realism and relaxed realism. In realism mode, you don't get icon indicators over your teammates' heads, so it is a little bit more difficult to tell when you're shooting at a friendly. You do kind of need to learn the uniforms and be a little bit more careful before you fire your shots to make sure you don't kill teammates. Oh well, whatever, all is fair. I did team kill before, so I guess I am not a saint either. Either way, I'm pushing up here once again, trying to be extremely aggressive, throwing down some smoke. I am the commander. Commanders and squad leaders gain access to smoke, which allows the rest of your team to push forward, and it is insanely crazy in this game. I guess you could say overpowered. Just like team chat is overpowered, you should be throwing smoke to cover your advances. What I'm walking through right here is actually an Axis stronghold. On the other side of that smoke is a big building where a lot of people love to camp. I'm using that to block me. You can even see I was standing there not worried about taking fire because there is that giant smoke screen right there, and I'm able to be insanely aggressive once again. No real problem that I died before. A lot of people in this game way too afraid of dying. You need to get out there, be aggressive, but be smart about how you're aggressive. Be careful, throw down smoke and stuff like that, but the rewards for being aggressive when you know what you're doing are very high. You can see a lot of people camping up here, clearing that out for my teammates. You can usually expect to find at least one person laying on the ground there, usually an HMG or whatever. I come back here later, and once again it is the case that someone is here again, trying to fire down on these people. Unfortunately, look at Hans in the window. Hans, Ferdinand, whatever is a stupid generic German name, I don't know, but what are you doing looking out that window? For all you who don't know, looking out that window, being on his team, is like checking to make sure his teammates are spawning. Like, oh, look out the window, cool, my teammates are respawning. And then, yeah, cool, good information. So, anyway, I died, but I'm coming back expecting to do the exact same thing because it is so effective, and this is such an unexpected route for the Axis to expect any Russians to be going through. This area is actually one we're supposed to be capturing. By throwing the smoke here and turning left, I am completely ignoring an objective. It is just really weird for someone to run through here and try and take this path. I never see anyone do it. So quickly getting behind people here immediately already. Quick kill on this guy. They are all trying to defend the propaganda house right over there on the left. 3 kills before I even get into this house, which was my main objective. I want to get back onto the top of those stairs once again, because usually there are people camping up there. Let's see again. There's an HMG again, and there's a sniper here right next to him. You don't need 2 people camp in the same spot, by the way. You don't need that. You absolutely don't. So quick reload. The next plan of my attack is to run out this door, see if there's anyone looking out these windows. Oh! Whoa, hey, Ferdinand. Nice to meet you again. You are a generic. So this is actually the Axis spawn, pretty much. They spawn in this building, so I run up here. I usually try and get some quick picks on this window. The commander will chill in here a lot because there's a radio as well. But it was kind of weird to not find a single German in this entire building. Usually it is stacked to the brim with people. So I make the dumb rookie mistake of staring out one of these windows. My teammates are attacking from the completely opposite direction, and I can't blame them up there in those windows, shooting me right in the face. I deserve that one. You look out a window where I just said you can expect Germans to be looking out of at all times, yeah, I'm gonna get shot. That's not their fault. That was my fault. But immediately after that, we won anyway. People actually got on the point, captured it. Very quick win there. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, please press the like button. Really helps me out. And now we've got the fancy scoreboard. If you want to tell me how awesome I am and how big my ego should be, that would be fantastic. But before that, let me know if you want to see more Red Orchestra 2.